Welcome to worship here at Trinity. Trinity is a congregation of the Evangelical Lutheran Church in America, located in Marshalltown, Iowa. We begin with the words that were spoken and the sign that was marked upon us in our baptism. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Let us call to mind the need we all have for God's mercy. Lord Jesus, all the grace we need we find in you. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, all that we lack you can provide. Christ, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, all our sins you do forgive. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. This is the good news. God is mercy, and in the name of Jesus, our sins are forgiven. Amen. Sisters and brothers in Christ, beloved children of God, grace, mercy, and peace be with you all. Let us pray. Almighty God, the resplendent light of your truth shines from the mountaintop into our hearts. Transfigure us by your beloved Son and illuminate the world with your image. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. A reading from the book of Exodus. Moses came down from Mount Sinai. As he came down from the mountain with the two tablets of the covenant in his hand, Moses did not know that the skin of his face shone, because he had been talking with God. When Aaron and all the Israelites saw Moses, the skin of his face was shining, and they were afraid to come near him. But Moses called to them, and Aaron and all the leaders of the congregation returned to him, and Moses spoke with them. Afterward, all the Israelites came near, and he gave them in commandment all that the Lord had spoken with him on Mount Sinai. When Moses had finished speaking with them, he put a veil on his face. But whenever Moses went in before the Lord to speak with him, he would take the veil off until he came out. And when he came out and told the Israelites what he had been commanded, the Israelites would see the face of Moses, that the skin of his face was shining. And Moses would put the veil on his face again until he went in to speak with him. Word of God, word of life, Thanks be to God. Alleluia, this is my son, my chosen. Listen to him. Alleluia. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. Now, about 8 days after these sayings, Jesus took with him Peter and John and James and went up on the mountain to pray. And while he was praying, the appearance of his face changed, and his clothes became dazzling white. Suddenly they saw two men, Moses and Elijah, talking to him. They appeared in glory and were speaking of his departure, which he was about to accomplish at Jerusalem. Now Peter and his companions were weighed down with sleep, but since they had stayed awake, they saw his glory and the two men who stood with him. Just as they were leaving him, Peter said to Jesus, "Master, it is good for us to be here. Let us make three dwellings, one for you, one for Moses, and one for Elijah," not knowing what he said. While he was saying this, a cloud came and overshadowed them, and they were terrified. As they entered the cloud, then from the cloud came a voice that said, "This is my son, my chosen, listen to him." When the voice had spoken, Jesus was found alone, and they kept silent, and in those days told no one any of the things they had seen. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Dear friends, I greet you in the name of Jesus, our Savior. Amen. We are familiar with what goes up must come down. And I would add, what comes down must go up. In the Transfiguration story, Jesus goes up the mountain with Peter, James, and John. And a lot happens up there. Moses and Elijah, they show up and they talk with Jesus. We're not exactly sure about what, but it had something to do with what was going to happen in Jerusalem. And we're told that the clothes of Jesus became bright white, and then a big cloud came and overshadowed them, and the voice of God spoke, "This is my son, my chosen, listen to him." And Peter wanted to stay up on the mountain, but Jesus called them back down the mountain, where immediately Jesus healed the son of two very distraught parents. And then it says he set his face towards Jerusalem. Jesus went up to commune with God, and then he came down to serve a family in need. To enter into intimacy with God, up, if you will, is always to be called down, if you will, to serve others. And to be down in a life of service is then to be drawn back up into intimacy with God so that we can be renewed and strengthened. That is the rhythm of life the rhythm of engagement and then withdrawing. Up and down, down and up. That is the rhythm of Jesus' life. Jesus engages in a busy life, a life of healing and feeding and teaching. And yet we also see him disengaging. We see him withdrawing, whether it's going up a mountain or to someplace else, so that he can be refreshed and renewed, so that he can pray. There is a moment in Jesus' life when he is at Peter's house, or perhaps it's Peter's mother-in-law's house, we don't know for sure. But he is at the house, and it says that in the evening, the whole city was gathered around the house at the door, and Jesus was engaged. He was busy healing the sick and casting out demons. But then in the morning, before the sun came up, Jesus got up, and we are told that he left. He disengaged. He went away to a lonely place to pray, to be renewed. This is the pattern. Jesus lived a balanced life, a life of up and down, a life of engagement and withdrawal. And that should be the rhythm of our relationship with God and with our neighbor. Our engagement in service to our neighbor is supported by our taking time to withdraw, to be renewed and refreshed, to be strengthened. It is a matter of balance in our lives. We are called to be engaged. We are called to care passionately and actively for our neighbor and for this world. But to do so, we must also tend to ourselves. We must care for ourselves, and we must be spiritually refreshed by withdrawing like Jesus, whether it's up a mountain or to a lonely, quiet place. I have always appreciated the ministry of Pope John the 23rd. And his favorite title for himself was Servant of the Servants of God, expressing the kind of humility he had. But there is a bedtime prayer that he is said to have used, and the prayer went like this. Pope John the 23rd would pray, God, I've done the best I could in your service this day. So, Lord, I'm going to bed now. It's your church. Take care of it. That is an up and down life, a life of engagement and withdrawal, a balanced life. In our lives, we need to plan time to disconnect. Jesus did it all the time. He disconnected. We need to stop being and just be. We need to be renewed and refreshed in the same promise that Jesus received when he went up the mountain by himself with his disciples. The promise that we are God's beloved. So I know for myself, and I think for all of us, we need to listen to our spirits. We need to listen to our hearts. We need to listen to our bodies, because they will tell us when we need to take a break from the down and need to go up, when we need to take a break from engagement and we need to withdraw and be renewed. You see, the world won't stop if we step aside for a while. If we go up the mountain or withdraw to a lonely place, the world will not stop. The world will not stop if we take time to read a book just for fun, or if we go take a hike along the river, or if we watch a few episodes of Diners, Drive-Ins, and Dives, or if we sit on the beach or next to the pool with an umbrella drink. The world will go on, but we will be better because we took the time to disengage, as Jesus did, to be refreshed and to be renewed. It is balance. It is up and down. It is engaged, and it is withdrawal. We need daylight and darkness. We need conversation and silence. We need community and solitude. We need work and play. We need engagement, and we need withdrawal. We need both up and down, just like Jesus. Amen. We confess our faith. I believe in God the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. We are called to love and follow the way of Jesus. He invites us to offer our prayers in confidence that he hears us and responds. Enlighten your church and help us listen to Jesus and follow him. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Restore your creation to vibrancy and beauty, and open our eyes to see your splendor in all that has been created. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. By the example of Jesus, teach our parish community the way of humility and peacemaking. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Shine the light of your love into each one of us and inspire us to carry that love to others in this coming week. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We ask that you would fill the leaders of nations with a desire to turn away from war and to pursue the way of peace. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You are the strength of the sick and suffering, the lonely and forgotten, the fearful and despairing. Shine the light of your love upon those whom we name in our hearts before you. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. You call forth leaders for your church. Bless our bishops Elizabeth and Amy with a strong faith and a gentle spirit. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Trusting in your love, O God, we commend to you all for whom we pray, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. O God, receive these gifts as you receive us, like a mother receives her child with arms open wide. Nourish us anew with your tender care and empower us in faithful service to tend to others with the same love we have received. Through Jesus Christ, our saving grace. Amen. I invite you to stand. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. We lift them to the Lord. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is right to give God thanks and praise. It is indeed right, our duty and our joy, that we should at all times and in all places give thanks and praise to you, Almighty and merciful God, through our Savior Jesus Christ, who sharing our life lived among us to reveal your glory and love, that our darkness should give way to your own brilliant light. And so, with all the choirs of angels, with the church on earth and the hosts of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn. Holy God, you alone are holy, you alone are God. The universe declares your praise. Beyond the stars, beneath the sea, within each cell, with every breath, we praise you, O God. Generations bless your faithfulness through the water, by night and day, across the wilderness, out of exile, into the future. We bless you, O God. We give you thanks for your dear Son at the heart of human life, near to those who suffer, beside the sinner, among the poor, with us now. We thank you, O God. On the night before he was given up to death, a death he freely accepted, he took bread and gave you thanks. He broke the bread, gave it to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. This is my body, which will be given up for you. Do this in memory of me." When the supper was ended, Jesus took the cup. "Again, Father, he gave you thanks and praise. Gave the cup to his disciples and said, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the cup of my blood, the blood of the new and everlasting covenant. It will be shed for you and for all people so that sins may be forgiven. Do this in memory of me." God of life, we remember before you those of our parish whose anniversary of death we commemorate this week: Thomas, Bob, Lida, Pinky, Harold, Robert, Olive, and Josephine. We rejoice in the gift of eternal life they now enjoy in heaven with you and all the saints who have gone before us. Also, remembering Jesus' love for us on the way, at the table, and to the end, we proclaim the mystery of faith. We pray for the gift of your Spirit in our gathering, within this meal, among your people throughout the world. Through him, with him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Together we pray as Jesus has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. The peace of Christ be with you always. Peace be with you. Peace be with you. Welcome you. Let us pray. Jesus, at this table, we share in your very life and are strengthened for our journey. Send us forth nourished in body and spirit to proclaim your good news and serve others in your name. Amen. Loving God, bless our families and fill our homes with respect, joy, laughter, and prayer. Especially send your blessing upon Brad and Deb and their family, Alan and Karen and their family, Larry and Marcia and their family. Protect them, guide them, and deepen their love for you. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you. God, who leads us in pathways of compassion, who rejoices over us and calls us by name, bless our going out and our coming in today and forever. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go with Jesus into a weary world. Share the good news. Thanks be to God.